So Jess sent me a montage of all the images at 128 BPM.
Exactly.
Yep. So that they would, and then so that I was going to burn them into the Heroes by David Bowie, which is going to be our big kind of emotional end. And she sent it to me, and I started trying to put the music onto it, and I just started crying like all over the place because it was just such a beautiful celebration. You approached me by a mutual friend.
I did, didn't I? Yes, Grant Ray, the journalist friend. And I suppose it first happened because of my project FlipSide.
Right.
Which was a project, if you remember, all about...
tinnitus.
It was, well, that was part of it, yeah, and it was...
That was only part of it? Oh, right.
No, that was a major part, trying to encourage clubbers to take care of their ears. But also, it was a project about dance music and most important people in dance music. And I wrote a list, I think, originally. I wrote a little list which had all, 35 people in it, and you were top of my list.
Through a mutual friend, you just said, would you want to be part of this, like a charity shoot, and you can do exactly anything you want, which turned me on. And when I said something about doing it at the Amex with the Albion, you're like, oh, I think I could probably do that. I was like, okay, she means business then.
Yeah.
She's somebody who gets it done. But to be honest, the main thing was just looking at your pictures. Main thing was looking at the portraits you'd done and thinking, here's someone who knows how to take a portrait, how to get the character of the person, of the subject, which is quite a difficult thing to do, I think.
And then before we came to Amex, we discussed various ideas though, didn't we? It was all about, because it was your flip side, so what you do outside of dance music, and you have loads of things you like doing. Like there was fishing we discussed, there was fishing, cooking, a lot of different things.
All quite dull to look at.
All quite dull, but we ended up on
the football thing. That stuck.
And that was your love, wasn't it? Brighton Hove album.
Yeah. And like you said you could get me into the players' dressing room.
I did do that.
You did.
Yeah. And I sent you a picture. Do you remember a little picture I sent you? A little drawing of what I think it could look like.
I do, yeah.
Yeah. Because I remember you seeing it and seeing, I drew you with a six pack.
And I said, if you can give me a six pack, then we're in business.
With FlipSide specifically, it was a nice way of getting to know somebody because you chat about, what you're into. And it was, I think my process is very much, it's drawing the picture, coming up with the idea, isn't it, the concept, and then seeing what happens when we get there.
Yeah, well, it being the most complete portrait that you can have in one frame, where you try and capture the whole character of the person just in the one shot, which, like I said, is a very difficult thing to do, but you seem to put it off, mainly by doing a huge amount of preparation, research into the character of the person you're doing, and then putting them in an environment where they, A, feel comfortable, but B, feel interesting. I hated the process of having my photo taken, but your genius was to make that process fun and productive, and hence you're about the only person I let take my photo these
days. Thank you, yeah. You have a certain amount of trust in me, which I find is really empowering in that respect, that if, I said, this is going to look good, you go with it.
It's weird because I'd say almost the opposite. I think that the trust is that if I say, I don't want to do that,
you go,
that's fine, like that. You don't try and carry on and talk me into it.
No, I think we just move on. We've killed shoots like that before, haven't we? I think we tried, a leaf blower one with wind.
Oh, Christ, it's a leaf blower.
It was a great idea, wasn't it? And then we tried it, and then... It wasn't good, was it?
I had the idea that, when you go really fast in the air, your cheeks inflate.
Yeah.
Mm. I wanted to do something like that would look quite grotesque, but we tried it, and having a leaf blower in your mouth is not only very, very distinctly uncomfortable and weird, but it just looked wrong. It was the wrong kind of grotesque.
It was wrong. We looked at the picture, didn't we, and we were like, no,
when we're just messing around, like, for instance, the helmet shot, the Born to Thrill shot, was it just a bit of a throwaway one? I bought it and I was like, oh, we haven't done one with this helmet on. Can we do a sort of like Apocalypse Now sort of shot?
Yeah.
And you went, yeah, get your shirt off, we'll do it. And
I like to do that.
Right at the end of the thing. And that has become really kind of iconic. That's a reoccurring thing. It's like you put me in a situation where all I have to do is stand there and look vaguely grumpy and the photo works. Rather than me like, do something wacky with your face, throw some shapes.
And we do play, I think the space helmet shot was us chatting over an evening, I remember that, and I think I'd sent you, and I'd say, what about a space helmet? Your mate, I sent you a picture. He said, my friend's got a space helmet. And he had the whole suit, didn't he? Just like
that. Yeah, an actual real,
the whole, yeah,
like Russian cosmonaut, yeah, suit. It wasn't a fake, it was a real one, yeah. Quite heavy though,
yeah, that helmet. Well, I think it's meant to be attached to a whole suit, isn't it? So it was wobbling a little bit, do you remember? So that's how we ended up doing the, which has become quite iconic, hasn't it, really? People do it with the whole hands in the
hand. Oh, I see, I see.
Well, you had to keep it stable, didn't it, really? You had to keep it stable.
Oh, of course, right, yeah.
And then it looked like you were closing your ears. So it's sort of, it's very organic.
For me, the most emotional and emotive one was the selfless, she did a series of portraits of, was it just NHS or was it all?
It was NHS and care workers during the first UK lockdown.
And so it was these really powerful portraits of the care workers during the first lockdown when everybody was just up against it and they hadn't been to bed for weeks. And just see, you could see it in their eyes. And I did a charity show for NHS and frontline workers, a free show at the Brighton Centre. So Jess sent me a montage of all the images at 128 BPM.
Exactly. Yep.
So that they would, and then so that I was going to burn them into the Heroes by David Bowie, which is going to be our big kind of emotional end. And she sent it to me, and I started trying to put the music onto it, and I just started crying like all over the place because it was just such a beautiful celebration of what had gone on, and we were now having a party at the end of the pandemic.
It really was.
And then when we showed it, it really it really worked because it was like everybody thought the show had finished and then I just played Heroes.
And you walked off, didn't you? You just played it and walked off. It felt like doing something really good. If you get pinch yourself moments, definitely. I think I remember one of your Wembley Arena shows and seeing, I just sat there for a second and I looked around. It was the Smiley Ball was the for the mouth one at the time. And there was T-shirts everywhere with this Smiley Ball. There were posters everywhere. When you look around at the audience, you know, what is it, 20, 30, I don't know how many thousands, many thousands. And then your show starts and the fat boy skinny going into the Christopher Walker video. And that's like, I remember just having a moment then thinking, wow, you know, this is a really big deal. I was really felt.
At this point, were you in one of like the galleries? Because you were trying to get that big panoramic shot. So you were probably in some gallery in the gods watching it all.
Just thinking, wow, this is amazing. Just to be a part of your Fatboy Slim, you know, your brand, your show. And that was quite amazing.
Has there ever been a moment in the last 10 years where it's like you thought, I am now his official photographer?
Yeah, no.
No, it was just a continuing series of stunts, capers, and fun, but in the meantime, even though we're not working together, we always have lunch every few months. You know, catch up. Yeah. It's a friendship as well.
Definitely a friendship. Rather than a good friendship now, isn't it?
Well, I think we started with you getting me to take the clothes off. It's like the ice was broken.
I like that. Yeah, and talking about big moments, that was a big moment for me. I think when we did this show and we played Cargo afterwards, and getting to DJ after you, which I thought was a really bad idea 5 minutes into your set. I thought, this is a really bad idea, DJing after Fatboy Slim. But I did cheat a little bit.
It's not something most people volunteer for.
No, I realised that 5 minutes into your set. Oh my God, what have I set myself up for here? That was terror. I think I was excited for this specific show because it's a Fatboy Slim show of 10 years of work. And whenever you could be on a random beach in Borneo and you mention you come from Brighton and people will say, oh, Fatboy Slim's town.
Or Brighton Hove Albion.
There's that. So I knew I wanted this show with this work to be in Brighton. I thought it had to be a Brighton show. And the only gallery I think that is suited is Enter Gallery, I think. What do you think on that?
Well, from my point of view, I've done sort of various collabs with the gallery over the years. Again, I mean, it is the sort of, you know, it's your one-stop shop for art in Brighton. Mm. And I've done various things. But again, like my relationship with you, I've done strange little things where it's like, we're not sure, will this work? And we did the thing with Mark Vesey. I feel safe. I trust the gallery.
Yeah.
I trust the gallery to say to me, yeah, that's a stupid idea or that's a good idea. And they thought this was a good idea. So they're sort of my sort of arbiters of what's, because I love art, but I don't really, I love it as a consumer, and I don't profess to understand how it really works. So I have these sort of ideas or collaborations or you know, the things we want to do, but I've no idea if it's really a good idea or not in the art world. So enter are quite good because they go, yeah, you could do that, or you could do this, or, you know, and then shape it into something that actually really works. I sort of go and talk to them, and if they say yes, it's probably a good idea.
It's a good idea, yeah. And I think the work suits the space, it suits the show. It's a very, you know, it feels like when you walk into Enter, it's a colourful gallery. It's got a lot of pop art in there. And a lot of our pictures we've done have become pop art, haven't they? They've been appropriated and...
Yeah, I mean, where else in the world or Brighton would you do it apart from Enter?
It's the Royal Gallery. So you want to come to Enter Gallery on 1st of March, because it's going to be our 10-year celebration, isn't it?
Yeah, no, it's just a celebration of our relationship together and the photos we've taken together and the results thereof.
Exactly. And they're all fun, aren't they? They're all joyous.
Well, so a lot of them very, very iconic. So, yeah, no, it's been a very productive 10 years, and it's a celebration of that. And set to music.